We are about 40 miles or so south of Candlestick Point at a place that first opened back in 2014. As you get a look at Levi's Stadium here in Santa Clara, California. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Levi's Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was deafening. They're set for football as the 49ers get ready to do battle with the Los Angeles Rams. On first down, gone. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now the 3rd leading rusher in the NFL last year, Todd Gurley. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
They'll try and pick up the 1st with Gurley. And he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. So opening drive, 3 straight runs, unable to pick up the 1st.
I know the fans want to see 1st downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it, and some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
James now to return. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Niners will go on offense. 1st and 10. Out come the 49ers again here for their next drive on offense. And San Francisco, as we said, got the win over New Orleans week 14.
That moved them. What a game. What a game.
You said, did you tell me that was maybe the best game you've ever called at the NFL level?
Well, there's no doubt in my mind at the NFL level. There was a couple of college games that were pretty good, that Boise State, Oklahoma, mm-hmm. and Appalachian State, Michigan. But as far as an overall game, number 1 on my list.
And speaking of number 1, the victory moved them back into the number 1 spot in the NFC by virtue of their win in New Orleans and the Seahawks losing to the Rams in L.A. on Sunday night. And what did you tell me, that 11-2 start is their best start since when?
1997. And not only that, for a West Coast team that has to play some meat.
And oh, his 1st carry, he loses the football. But an alert 49er able to gain possession, so they will indeed hold on to the pigskin.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. They'll throw out wide, complete to Sanders. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1-yard gain. A 1-yard gain there following the 3-yard pickup on 1st down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the 1st quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. 1st quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up 1st downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Kittle last year, what a season. 1,377 receiving yards, an NFL record for tight ends en route to his 1st Pro Bowl. Not bad for the former 5th round pick. I remember that game, December against Denver. He had that monster 1st half, 210 yards. Did not have a single catch in the 2nd half, but still those 210 yards were just 4 yards shy of Shannon Sharpe's single game record for a tight end. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
Brandon, that was a nice route that time. Lined him up on the right and worked his way all the way across the formation. One of the toughest routes to cover, because you keep waiting for the ball to be thrown and for him to break something off. He goes all the way across the field, right to left, for a big play.
Garoppolo now. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. The perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, they took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. Garoppolo gives to Breida. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. A 16-yard touchdown run as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. As the Rams set up shop for this next drive, Charles, let's talk about where they're at. They're 8-5. They're on a two-game winning streak. Big win in Week 14 against Seattle. And guess what the key to their victory was in Week 14?
What's the key?
Going back to what they did last year, pressure with their defensive line and a heavy dose of Todd Gurley.
Yeah, that pressure led to 5 sacks of Russell Wilson in the game. And Todd Gurley had 20-plus carries in the ball game, looking more like himself now. I wonder if the load management helped him to get him to this stage of the season. But they'll need everything down the stretch because not only do they have to win out, they're going to need some help along the way. They don't control their own destiny. At Dallas, at San Francisco, host Arizona, they're looking for some losses along the way, especially with Minnesota.
Now a draw as Goff gives to Gurley. And he powers his way up past the 30. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. Third and two, gone. And this is going to be incomplete.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on third down conversions to start this thing. On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. Twisting away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they got out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
Here we go. 180!
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Here we go. 180!
Once again, they run with Breida on first down. The tackle there by John Johnson.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast. Let's get it.
Here we go. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Titans Ringo. Titans on Ringo.
Now Garoppolo. Open man is born. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
They have the first down with that gain of 4 yards.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay?
Here we go.
I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Here we go.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a second and 6.
And here we go. Watch the pass.
Garoppolo after the fake give to Breida. He'll dump this down to Matt Breida. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it third and 1.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
Here we go.
The Rams calling on their nickel set here defensively for third down. They'll try and run for it here. It's Coleman. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Well, remember, Tevin Coleman was in the two-headed backfield in Atlanta during his 4 years there, along with Devontae Freeman. Now he joins a crowded backfield in San Francisco. But in Atlanta, he played under offensive coordinator Kyle Shanahan, and then, of course, Shanahan becomes a 49er head coach, and he made it a point to go out and snag his former running back because he really likes his 26-year-old ball carrier.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Here we go.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's second and 3. On second down, a run with Breida. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Switch.
Garoppolo, he's going to give this to Breida on the draw. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2. And it brings up second down.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
You ain't got nothing.
Now they'll throw with Garoppolo. Open man is Samuel, complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
Here we go. Black 80! Here we go.
Working from the gun, Garoppolo. And it's incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
Here we go.
They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal.
Get in the way, you.
Garoppolo. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
Garoppolo now on 3rd and goal. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Last year's NFL leader in field goal percentage, Robbie Gould, on for the Niners field goal. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. He will be brought down well shy of the goal line. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work. And that will force a turnover on downs. Now a first down throw. Gone. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Robert Woods, the intended receiver that time. But it's going to be 2nd down.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new-school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
And the open receiver, it's Robert Woods. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their 2nd, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. It's a gain of 15, and the Rams have a 1st down.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Goff throwing again. That'll be caught by Kopp. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
Your trip is here.
Here we go, fellas. Here we go.
So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman. This one fielded at the 5. And he nearly broke that for more, but as it is, they'll start this drive at about the 37-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this 3rd quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the 3rd quarter.
I like the way you term that because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
They run again with Breida, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two, now third down.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
Here we go.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on third.
Go! Man! Man!
From the gun, it's Garoppolo. Completes it to Samuel. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 36. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Garoppolo on the draw to Coleman. It's a four-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Here we go. 180!
Let's go D, tighten up. Let's go D, tighten up.
From the gun on third, Garoppolo. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Marching in for the sack, Michael Brockers.
Now that was just absolute perfect man coverage. Nowhere for them to go with the football, led to a sack. And that's really difficult to do in today's NFL with all these gazelles running around that you're trying to cover in the secondary.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. Now the attention turns back to the Rams offense as they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
16 yards is the pickup there and a first down for L.A. And he's got the hook up here. It's Woods. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and nine.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
On second and nine, Goff gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bit.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Credit the sack to the Oregon Duck, DeForest Buckner. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus-yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him. An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
That's going to be caught by Samuel. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run with Coleman on first down. He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Now it's Breida. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, 49ers. Matt Breida. His second touchdown of the night. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Gold with the extra point, and it's now 14-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded at the 8. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And you're still in this game. I mean, yeah, you haven't scored. Offense obviously has struggled, but you're only two scores down, so all hope not lost.
Not at all, because we were talking about the NFL, and teams can score fast in this league. Quick strikes, you're right back in it. You're exactly right, keeping hope alive.
Now it's gone, and that's complete to Cooks. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Goff, it's complete. This is Todd Gurley. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 41-yard line.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores. And they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? There's gone. And Woods has it complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It'll be a first down for the Rams there on a pickup of 18. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown as his guys are back within a single score. So very late in the game here, but with that score, some light at the end of the tunnel.
There's still hope. Now they look at the score and say, hold on a second. This thing's not over yet. Let's keep battling.
Zuerlein good with a PAT. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. Right now, clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays, they're going to gain yardage, how would you say it, consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first downs. And the goal, end the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
Here we go. Here an we go. Incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. This is Breida. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. This is third and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Let's go. The third down conversion. 5 yards on the play. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
Watch the run.
On first down, here's Breida. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Oh, Garoppolo's going to throw it. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop. 1:50 left in the football game.
Here we go, here we go.
Ball
here we
up
go.
To the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
Switch!
The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So second and nine, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. They run with Breida. And a solid run down inside the 30. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. On third down, a run from Breida. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. It's a gain of four, and that should just about seal the deal.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach, he's in big trouble.
So the victory here for San Francisco, and you look back over the score sheet, interesting. A very clean game, no turnovers by either side.
An absolute rarity when we watch games now because defenses have put such an emphasis on taking the ball away. Well, what we saw here was offenses spending their time saying, look, you know they're coming for it. Ball security is paramount. So they worked on that, not just a week of practice, but I'm sure all during training camp. Make sure when you have it, tuck it away because danger lurks everywhere you turn.